I was 13 or 14, I wrote my first song. And I was really, really shy about my voice. My trumpet teacher, he told me about this art school. I felt like I gotta be in a different surrounding. To be more creative, I gotta be with people that play better than me. I think like since day one, I just felt like a complete stranger. I was living in Bangkok in a tiny, tiny studio apartment in the 28th floor. Many times in my life, I need a trigger in order to really like be creative. And that's the point where I wrote Nevermind. And I remember listening to the song and I felt like this is different than anything that I ever created before. There's something there. I don't know what, but there's something there. And I felt like this can go global. Maybe I should get like a stage name, something that is more catchy than Nir Tibor. Hold up, let's rewind. So I got back from Bangkok and I had like so many goals that I wanted to achieve and I couldn't achieve any of them. I got like 40 something songs that I wrote. I started uploading my songs through different platforms. I had no money and I had to pay my bills, so I went to the falafel shop next to my house. Hey, can I work here? The guy said, yeah, sure, come next Monday. So the day after I got the job, I got like 13 or 14 emails from different record labels, all asking about Nevermind. And at some point I had to ask them, how did you find me? Bro, you gotta open Spotify and see what's going on. My question was, what the fuck is Spotify? And then I saw Nevermind on like top 50 viral charts in 14 or 15 countries. And then it happened. I got signed by a record label. And I felt like everything was really like happening suddenly. Then I wrote Never Go Back.
I never go back, no, no, no. I never go.
And I sent it to the label. I thought they would be excited, but they weren't. I want to release a song that I know that's like a hit and they don't want it. Then I realized that this relationship with the record label isn't working. I felt stuck. This is your childhood dream. This is what you worked for. This is what you crave for. The same moment, you see Nevermind just like blowing up more and more and more in their shows and festivals. Everything was happening and I was sad. I had no motivation to do anything.
Sometimes in life, it seems really, really long for you. And when you think like that you reached the bottom, it's only getting worse. And like, what the fuck is gonna end it, you know?
In 2018, we had litigation in London. We got into a room, a big table, 15 people all wearing suits and ties, and I'm asking myself, these people control me? They control my life? I felt like a lion in a cage. If we leave London without this settlement, we are fucked. This was the first time that I ever felt suicidal. And it felt reasonable, you know what I'm saying? I was like, yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna drop all my music online, say goodbye, and that's it. That was the lowest moment of my life.
The lights turn on, where would I go? Some days I'm high, some days I'm low. Where would I go?
I think the hardest part for me was that I couldn't share the story with anyone. My fans, they had no idea, why aren't you like releasing more music? And I couldn't answer. I'm gonna tell my fans what's going on.
Let me tell you something about the suits, all right? They don't give a fuck about me. They don't give a fuck about my music, my vision, my creativity, my fucking life. I got one thing that they don't have and they will never have. I got you.